guys. 7:35.
Good morning, Glenrock community. I'm your lead anchor, Connor Bratsbys.
And I'm your co-anchor, Aaron Arona.
And this is Season 1, Episode 22 of GR Morning News.
Today is October 1st, and it is a day 4 in our rotation schedule. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance, recited by 8th grade student Edward Matrano.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated.
Dive right into our morning announcements. Connor, what news do you share with us today?
Check out what the Thrive Club is all about. Join us at our interest meeting on Tuesday, October 1st in room D217 during lunch A. Bring a friend. There will be snacks. Questions? Contact Ms. Forsaw or Ms. Wanigale.
The interest meeting for the Arts for All Club, which was to be held on October 1st, has been postponed. We will let you know when it has been rescheduled.
The Cultural Exchange Club is offering a trip to Costa Rica this spring from March 6th through 13th. It is open to current and former Spanish students and environmental science students in grades 10 through 12. We will be doing a variety of fun and interesting activities, such as a visit to an indigenous reserve, a visit to a tropical farm, zip lining, and a surf lesson. Is an amazing opportunity to use your Spanish and learn about Costa Rica's efforts to protect the environment and its wildlife and its culture. There will be an informational meeting on Monday, October 7th at 6 p.m. in room B150. Please message Senora Brewer on Schoology if you are interested.
Attention all Glenrock High School students. The first ever meeting of Dungeons & Dragons Club is taking place on Tuesday, October 1st, right after school in room B150. At this meeting, Mr. Rowan will explain how the club will work and what to expect for the year. Anyone is welcome to join, regardless of skill level or experience with the game. If you are interested in joining a club but are unable to attend our first meeting, please email Mr. Rowan at rowans@glenrocknj.org. We look forward to seeing you there.
The bowling team will have a preseason meeting on Tuesday, October 8th at 3 p.m. in D129, the high school health room. Please contact Coach Zimmerman if you have any questions.
Attention middle school students, do you like to write, draw, paint, take pictures? Join a middle school literary arts magazine. Our first chill and create session will be on Tuesday, October 8th in room A210. Bring your lunch and spend the period creating something awesome to share in our end of the year magazine. If you have any questions, please see Mrs. Simpson.
Attention all middle school and high school students. If you want to be a member of the dance club, our first informational meeting will be on Wednesday, October 2nd in room A210 right after school. Come meet the officers and see what we have planned for the year. If you want to be added to our Schoology group, please message Ms. Simpson.
Hey seniors, order your class of 2025 t-shirts. Order forms are on our Schoology page. There are shirts for your parents too, so be to make sure to have them participate in this fun fundraiser. Order forms and payments must be returned no later than October 7, 2024, by the end of the school day.
Good morning to all members of the Model UN. We will be attending a conference at Seton Hall University on February 8th at and 9th on 2025. Costs to follow soon. Anyone interested in attending should fill out the general interest form that is located in the Seton Hall 2025 folder on our Schoology page. Thank you.
Interact is a club that raises money for the American Parkinson's Disease Association. We'll be holding our first meeting on October 7th, which is a day 2, in room D223 during the first half of lunch. If you have lab, just reach out to let an officer know. We'll be discussing upcoming and future plans. Everyone is welcome.
Attention skiers and boarders. Interested in a weekend trip to Stratton, Vermont? The GRHS Ski/Snowboard Schoology group for details and to fill out an application for the trip.
Interested in the medical field? Please join us for our first HOSA club meeting on October 1st in room S114 during the second half of lunch. If you have any questions or are unable to attend, reach out to either Yeji Kim at yejikimy25@glenrocknj.org or Ms. Hughes at hughesm@glenrocknj.org. We hope to see you there.
High school students who need service hours. Why not contribute to the GR community at the dog park? We pull weeds and shovel the gravel back into place. Interested high school students, email Mrs. Scotty and meet at the dog park on Tuesday, October 1st at 5 p.m. Try to bring gardening gloves and a snow shovel.
Did you sign up for the middle school art club at the club walk-around? If so, you've been added to the Schoology group. Please fill out the Google form posted in the group by Wednesday, October 2nd, 2024. Thank you.
Calling all 6th through 9th grade students. If you're interested in Science Olympiad, please attend a meeting in S238 after school on 10-2-24 and join our Schoology page with the code on screen.
Now let's go back in time. Here's your daily Rio and Rude Rowan.
Morning, everyone. Happy October, and welcome to another episode of Rewind with Rowan. Today, for October 1st, we're going to go back to 1908 and some early 20th century American history. So on this day in 1908, the Ford Motor Company unveiled the Model T. Automobiles were a relatively new technology at the turn of the 20th century, but many people simply could not afford them. Before the reveal of the Model T, there were only about 200,000 cars across the entire United States. However, the Model T was designed to be affordable and used by common people in their daily lives. Ford focused their advertising this way, saying that, quote, no car under $2,000 offers more, and no car over $2,000 offers more except the trimmings. The Ford factories in the area around Detroit, Michigan greatly expedited production of the Model T. The assembly line system for car manufacturing allowed Ford to use unskilled labor to consistently produce a large number of Model T automobiles. Between 1908 and 1927, about 15 million Model T cars were manufactured. However, as the Roaring Twenties continued, people were no longer interested in the common look and function of the Model T. They desired something more luxurious, fast, and unique. Ford continues to be a famous car manufacturer the world over, but a lot of the history of the Ford brand is tied directly to that original Model T vehicle. The last Model T completed its journey across the assembly line in May 1927, marking the end of an era for the car manufacturer and early 20th century America as a whole. That's it for today. Back to the show.
Thanks, Mr. Rowan.
Make sure to check out Schoology for any last-minute updates and announcements.
Faculty, staff, and students, don't forget to scan the QR code so you can share your story or event live right here on the GR News Morning Show.
We're on most social media platforms. You can find us at Glenrock Media on YouTube, Instagram, and TikTok.
This is your lead anchor, Connor Bratsby's.
And I'm your co-anchor, Aaron Arona, signing off for today. Until tomorrow, remember,
you can't stop the rock.